まあ、テクノロジーが一番面白いことは何かっていうと、その不可能を可能にするっていうことだと思うんですね。僕が最初作り始めるときはワクワクすることを感じてから、今回やってる、フェイスマッピングはポストプロダクションでリアルタイムで CG を顔に投射してやっています。なのでインテルの CPU はもう水とか空気のようなもので、もうそれがなくては何もできないっていうもの、正確にこう 3D でこう取得します。 3D のスキャニングをする機械の中にも入っているし、でその 3D でできたモデルの上にコンピューターグラフィックを作っていって、作るコンピューターの中にも入っているし、プロジェクションでお面をかぶせるようなイメージで、投影します。投影するためのコンピューターの中にもインテルチップが入っているので、見てくれた人が喜んで楽しんでくれた時に最も喜びが湧いてきます。そうするともっと面白いことをやりたいって思います。
It looks like your average city skyline, but in fact, these images are just an elaborate optical illusion. The amazing mirage appeared over Huangshan City in East China at dusk on Thursday. Following a heavy downpour, the spectacular images of mountains, buildings, and trees appeared in the thin mist above the Xin'an River.The phenomenon began at about 5 p.m. local time, to the amazement of passers-by.
It's really amazing. It looks like a scene in the movie, in a fairyland.
Although residents say that similar sights have been seen lately, most agreed that this one had been the most impressive.
Thank you. Viene sostituirla per poi vedi questa qua è una cosa.
I'm gonna get my girls to come and have a look. It's not your imagination. What's happening? Who's there?
These service personnel playing the role of an unruly mob at Georgia's Moody Air Force Base are about to fall prey to an invisible ray. The hulking panel atop this Humvee is part of what the U.S. military calls the Active Denial System, or ADS. It's designed to incapacitate enemy combatants with an unnerving, non-lethal sensation of intense heat. Watch as the ray silently strikes and scatters the crowd.
The active denial system has three great characteristics. First of all, it's safe. Second, it's effective. And third, it has a tremendous range compared to the other non-lethal weapons that today's warfighter has.
This is the heart of this 100 kilowatt transmitter. This is the gyrotron. 200 kilowatts of electricity is fed in, and 100 kilowatts of radio frequency comes out. That millimeter wave energy comes out an aperture underneath the main reflector, hits the subreflector, which illuminates that main reflector, and sends a roughly antenna-sized beam downrange. Those holes that you see in the antenna are for the cameras and other visual equipment that the operator uses so that he knows exactly where that beam is going.
It's operated by a joystick. The operator looks into the console, sees exactly what that antenna is aimed at, moves the joystick left, antenna slews to the left. Same way to the right. Then when there's an individual who's identified as a troublemaker, he has a cursor, he can put that cursor on that individual, pull the trigger that's on the joystick, and the energy is sent downrange at the speed of light.
The electromagnetic radiation released by the active denial system is similar to the microwaves in your microwave oven, in that it causes the water molecules in the target to become excited and heat up. But that's where the similarity ends. The ADS is designed to heat only the very surface of the skin. It does this by outputting only the carefully chosen radio wave frequency of 95 gigahertz. Even though it can easily penetrate clothing, the ADS generates a much shorter and safer wavelength of radio waves than those used in microwave ovens.
The active denial system millimeter wave directed energy beam reaches 1/64th of an inch into human skin. So that is the most outermost layer of the skin, roughly equivalent to about three sheets of notebook paper. It is essentially affecting the pain nerves in the outermost layer of the skin, heating them up and causing an immediate repel effect.
Even these stoic servicemen, aware of what's about to happen,
engage,
can't help but flinch when they feel the heat.
This is the first time I've experienced the beam from the active denial system, and it feels like an intense warmth feeling, kind of similar to opening a very hot oven door, and it's a compelling feeling that you want to get out of the way of this beam. If you were not expecting this, it would definitely shock you and make you want to move.
The ADS represents just the latest effort to devise an effective ray weapon.
Aaron Alexis arrives at the Washington Navy Yard complex in his rental car, passing through this door with a bag which contains his gun. This is a chilling video released by the FBI and shows Alexis prowling the corridors hunting for victims. As he checks his sawn-off shotgun, he walks with purpose down the hallway to commit murder, crouching and staying out of sight, looking both ways briefly before moving on. Down the hallway, there are people unaware of who is approaching. The FBI also released images of the weapon, a Remington 870 shotgun, which had messages etched on the side. Better off this way. And my ELF weapon. An apparent reference to extremely low frequency waves. Officials reckon he believed he was being controlled by them in the months before he killed 12 people. The FBI say there are no indications that Alexis was targeting anyone in the rampage and that he acted alone. The shooting spree and the question of how Alexis got security clearance to enter the base have prompted calls for a review of government vetting of private contractors.
The U.S. Navy faces many threats. One representative threat is unmanned aerial systems, or UASs. Conventional weapons, such as missiles and projectiles, are important to ship defense, but they're expensive, limited, and require time to engage a target. High-energy lasers augment conventional systems by providing speed of light engagements with reduced collateral damage at tactically significant ranges, with cost savings realized by minimizing the use of defensive missiles and projectiles. The Naval Sea Systems Command's Directed Energy and Electric Weapons Systems Program Office, or PMS 405, is investigating the use of high-energy laser systems on Navy surface ships. One such system is the Navy Laser Weapon System, or LAWS. The Directed Energy Warfare Office, or DEWO, of the Naval Surface Warfare Center in Dahlgren, Virginia, is the technical direction agent for LAWS. NSWC Dahlgren has been performing laser research, development, test, and evaluation for decades. LAWS is a system under development that tracks targets and engages them by combining six high-energy lasers into one powerful beam of light. The current LAWS prototype consists of the laser sources, power systems, cooling units, sensors, tracking and control hardware, and a custom beam director on a Comito mount. The mount moves the LAWS beam director to keep the laser pointed at the target. LAWS is planned to be integrated with and complement the capabilities of the Mark 15 Close-In Weapon System, or CWIS. CWIS is a computer-controlled, rapid-fire, radar-guided 20mm autocannon that shoots at close-in air and surface threats. CWIS was developed by the Program Executive Office for Integrated Warfare Systems, or PEO IWS 3BC, along with its prime contractor, Raytheon Missile Systems. In 2009, LAWS was tested against UASs in a desert environment at the Naval Air Warfare Center in China Lake, California. A team of scientists and engineers from NSWC Dahlgren, Computer Sciences Corporation Innovative Science and Technology Experimentation Facility, Pennsylvania State University Electro-Optic Center, and L3 Brashear set up and operated the LAWS system and instrumentation. The CWIS was not part of this test. The UASs were launched and flew a realistic flight pattern for engagement by the LAWS system at tactical distances. The test at China Lake was a complete success, locating, tracking, and shooting down five UASs at different ranges. Each of them caught fire, lost control, fell to the desert floor, and crashed, causing complete destruction of the UAS. The test demonstrated the capability of the LAWS system. In 2010, LAWS was tested against a threat representative UAS target in an over-the-water combat representative scenario at San Nicolas Island, California. This remote island, about 60 miles off the coast of California near Ventura, provided realistic and challenging maritime conditions. During this test, LAWS was connected to a CWIS system which provided designation or initial pointing data to the LAWS system. Scientists and engineers from NSWC Dahlgren operated the LAWS system and instrumentation, while CWIS was operated by Raytheon. The UASs were flown over the ocean for engagement by the LAWS system. The test at San Nicolas Island was also a complete success, locating, tracking, and destroying four UASs. These were the Navy's first detect-through-engage laser shoot-downs in a maritime environment. LAWS program manager Captain David Keel said, The success of this effort validates the military utility of directed energy weapons in a maritime environment. Further development and integration of increasingly more powerful lasers into laws will increase both the engagement range and target sets that can be successfully engaged and destroyed. Other targets were also successfully engaged during the San Nicolas Island test. The highly successful tests at China Lake and San Nicolas Island show that LAWS is a capable, effective, and accurate system in both desert and maritime environments. The next step is integrating LAWS with a ship and the SeaWiz. LAWS is also a low-risk, high-payoff technology. It's the Surface Navy's first tactical development for fielding of a directed energy weapon system. LAWS represents a game-changing technology that will provide Navy ship commanders with a new weapon that has nearly instantaneous time of flight, a deep magazine, and the ability to conserve defensive missiles and projectiles for use on other targets.
I can understand honoring those that served in the Revolutionary War or the War of 1812 who actually fought for freedom against a foreign tyranny. But for the most part, every single war since then has been created by cunning men for power and profit. While individuals sacrifice themselves on the altar of some collectivist lie that only spreads debt and death in the end. What is worse is that these wars were almost always started by false flags or provocation by these cunning men in the United States. Lincoln purposely started the Civil War with economic tariffs and Fort Sumter. We were involved in opium wars against China, supporting the drug importation of opium into China for silver. These foreign invaders into China is a direct cause of the rise of Mao. The USS Maine was not attacked by Spain. The Lusitania was an arms transport that violated the neutrality agreement, and Germany even warned us about it. The Federal Reserve funded the Bolshevik Revolution. The Bank of England funded the rise of Hitler. Even Pearl Harbor was provoked by an oil embargo, and we knew that they were coming, which is why all the aircraft carriers were away from Pearl Harbor when they attacked. The Gulf of Tonkin incident never happened, but 2 to 4 million people died as a result of the war that followed that, and for what? We funded CIA drug money into many Central American wars. We created the Mujahideen and Al-Qaeda with Zbigniew Brzezinski. And now we're finding out that even ISIS is created by the CIA to destabilize Syria for a war that we couldn't start from a false flag that was created by the CIA. We overthrew a democratically elected president in Iran because he wanted a 50-50 split of oil revenue. We then supported Saddam Hussein in the Iran-Iraq war that cost Iran 1 million men. 9/11 was a false flag. And the first people we go to fight is the Taliban, who just so happened to eradicate the heroin crop in Afghanistan that the Anglo-American Empire profits off of. And since we've been there, opium production has been at record levels and HSBC was recently caught laundering drug money, which, oh by the way, HSBC was created in the opium wars to launder drug money back then. And yet we are still here hero-worshipping these young men that sacrificed themselves to these lies for these cunning men that spread debt and death throughout the world. All of this ends when the individuals wake up to these facts and decide to no longer empower these psychopathic collectivists and their lies and power, to no longer volunteer for their military, to no longer be a debt slave, to no longer buy their consumerism, to no longer vote in their rigged elections, to no longer work in their corporations. They don't control us. We empower them.